Alright mga boss, alam nyo ba na ngayon January 30 hanggang February 1 ay magaganap ang Asian Summit Conference at syempre napapanahon to dahil magaganap na nga or nagaganap na ang ASEAN Integration ngayon 2015 kaya napapanahon talaga to. Kaya makakasama natin ngayong umaga ang ilan sa mga organizers ng naturang summit. Unang-una kasama natin ngayon live sa studio si Dr. Elias Soria, ang Vice Chairman ng Universal Peace Federation. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
At kasama rin natin ang Secretary General and Vice Chairman ng Asian Peace and Unity Corps, walang iba kundi si Professor Irma Balulot. Good morning.
Good morning, Jules.
Alright, so direct to the point na po tayo, ano po ba ang pinaka-output or agenda nitong Asian Summit?
Ah, the agenda of the Asian Summit 2015 is the theme is toward peace, security, and human development in Asia and Pacific region. And dito sa organization na to, and particularly in this summit, we hope that we will have the participation from the different sectors of our society, okay, from the non-government organization, from the young people, from the academe, and all the faith-based
so
community.
All sectors talaga.
Yeah, all sectors, including the retired generals.
That's nice. Prof. Irma, marami pong agenda na nalatag si Sir ngayon. Bakit po ito yung mga points na naisip natin na maging focus?
Definitely, Jules, napaka-critical ng peace. We need personal peace, we need peace in the country, and we need peace in the region. Businesses know na pagka magulo, mahirap pumasok ang capital. Mm-hmm. Mahirap makahanap ng trabaho. Yung iba, hindi nila nakikita yon. Na kaya walang trabaho dahil magulo.
Yes.
So, kailangan peaceful. Now, at the same time, kahit peaceful, kung walang human capacity to do the work, may problema pa rin. Mm-hmm. And yet, sa pagtatrabaho, hindi lang technical skills. Mm-hmm. Ang kailangan din doon yung behavior ng tao.
Yes.
Kaya yung human development has to be both internal and external. In HR, we say, hire for attitude, train for skills.
Right.
You can train for skills, but attitude is most important. Kasi yun yung platform, yun yung basis, you know? So, kailangan yun, human development, peace, and security.
All right. 2015 is really big for the ASEAN region. Kasi
syempre,
all countries in the ASEAN will integrate in all almost all aspects, like economic, right, 2015 to 2020. Pero of course, isa sa mga challenges dito would be the culture, right? So, ano po yung pagtanaw ng mga organizers regarding dito? Ano ba yung mga dapat na paghandaan ng Pilipino para syempre maging handa tayo sa pag-integrate ng culture ng Thailand, ng Malaysia, Indonesia, etc.?
Regarding the culture, actually, our Executive Vice President for the Asian Peace and Unity Corps, Dr. Tony Roldan, was really telling us that in all aspects of the integration, more or less, nandoon na yung platform, nandoon na yung framework. Ang hirap na hirap sila is on the cultural part. So, he was telling me, Irma, what can we do about culture? Can we help about like intercultural marriages? Kasi in marriage, there is more tolerance of differences in culture.
Yes.
You know?
Religion pa.
Yes, yes. And even especially about religion, which is very sensitive to some people. So, yan yung tinitignan ngayon ng Asian Peace and Unity Corps. Although, of course, we're also looking at the preparedness of individuals and families to transact business or to render services to be able to take advantage of the opportunities that will come with this ASEAN integration. But especially about culture, you know, the tolerance, the willingness to understand that iba ang culture nila. Kasi the Philippines is very special eh. The Philippines, although we are also Asian, ASEAN, pero hindi tayo napaka masyadong collective unlike other cultures. Other cultures is clearly collective.
Yes.
Pero Philippines, ang collectiveness natin is only up to the family level.
Yes.
Hindi tayo masyadong concerned. Bahala na dyan.
The
yung national level. Yes. Yung community. Kaya sa atin, pag may basura, itatapon sa labas na bakuran. Itatapon sa sa kalsada.
Yes.
You know, in other cultures, their collective mindset culture is really for the nation.
Right.
So may adjustment talaga na gagawin on the part of the Filipinos.
Mm-hmm.
And perhaps through the ASEAN integration and also with the role that APOC, the Asian Peace and Unity Corps, is doing now, that we can really expand the mindset of the Filipinos to go into the national scheme. Kaya talking with the Secretary of National Defense, Voltaire Gazmin, when we had a courtesy call with him last year prior to our APOC conference, last December too, he agreed with us that very important value that we have to develop among Filipinos now, Patriotism.
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 So,
Jules.
So far, hindi pa rin siya ganun ka.
Hindi ganun ka sa ano sa Philippines, okay, atin, so it, family
medyo,
lang.
Medyo threatened yun, lalo na may integration ngayon.
Yes, yes. So dapat talaga, ano natin yun, maisabay natin yun, sir. Kailangan yung family, yes. And then family, the requirement of the family is aligned to the interest of the country.
Alright.
Otherwise, you will sacrifice the country for the sake of the family. That's okay. Not good.
Yung organization po ninyo, isa po yan sa maraming organizations ngayon na ASEAN ang focus.
But yes.
December 31, we are hoping that the ASEAN community will be established already, right?
Yes.
So ano po ba yung tingin nyo maging contribution ng summit na to and your organization para siyempre maihanda yung buong bansang Pilipinas para sa integration na to?
Well, the first one is that we are pushing for peace and unity and harmony. Of different cultures. Of course, these different cultures are actually driven by religious values. Mm-hmm. So, since in ASEAN, we have all these different kinds of religions, but since the values in each religion are particularly actually the same, para pareho na yung mga values ng different religions. And I think if we are going to nail on that,
yes.
Then we can have unity and peace and this is a time that religion would be able to become the resource for peace and, of course, push for development.
Alright, so yeah. Peace and unity ang
yes.
Focus natin. Ito yung pinaka-agenda
yes.
Natin for this summit. And that's
yes.
Very unique kasi yung iba more on economic, more on social-civic yung mga focus nila. So ito, peace and unity. And that's
yes.
Very
yes.
Important in this integration.
Yes.
So as we end, please do invite our viewers to attend this summit this January 30.
Yeah, so ladies and gentlemen, ang mga manunood natin sa ating Good Morning Boss with our host here, Jules, we invite you to please join us in Manila Hotel on January 30 to 31 for the ASEAN Summit. You may call our secretariat with numbers
924-1833 or 928-881. Again, 924-1833. And 928-8881.
Alright. So, sabi nga, we could be critical with how will the integration will go, but we have no choice. Pero kailangan natin
yes.
Makisabay na sa integration.
Yes.
So, thank you so much for doing this summit and hopefully maging successful to.
Yes.
Thank you once again.
You.
We have here live in the studio the Vice Chairman of the Universal Peace Federation, Dr. Elias S. Soria, and the Secretary General and Vice Chairman of the ASEAN Peace and Unity Corps, Professor Irma A. Balulo. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Thank you.
Once
you.
More, I would like
you.
To thank. Good
sure.
Morning.
Our
boss.
Pleasure. Our pleasure.
Yeah.
Thank you so
thank
much
you.
For being
have
here.
Given us
thank
this opportunity
yes.
To be able to air our program.
All right.
So that yeah,
yes.
All those who have
yeah.
Hard still
yes.
Thinking would really come and participate.
Thank
this
you.
Is an opportunity for the Philippines to not only think about the Philippines,
thank
but
so
think
much.
ASEAN, act local.
Yes, thank
yes.
You.